In this example, we can get it into Power Query. So it's already a table. Let's get into Power Query. So that's what it looks like. Now I know I'm probably not going to want these two, so I've highlighted those two. I'm just going to remove the columns. And I know at the end here I've got some average, and I'm just going to remove that. So quite quickly we get to basically what we need. Now question is this a transpose or is it an unpivot? So I know I need to have it listed year one, then January, February, March, etc. So let's try transpose. If I go transpose, you'll see although it kind of does it, I actually need the years to be coming down here. So it's not what I want. I'm just going to delete it. So it looks like let's try an unpivot. Now just be careful. So I'm going to go and highlight these. And if I unpivot it, that's okay, but can you see we've got a slight problem here? This just doesn't make sense. So what you have to be careful with the unpivot, we need to include the headings as headings. So the first thing I'm going to do is just say use that first row as headings. So now we can see year 1, 2, 3, 4, month 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. I'm going to highlight all of those. I'm then going to go and unpivot the columns. So now you can see we've got year 1, year 2. We got, it says attribute, but these are the months. So I would now maybe change that to be the word year, change that to be the word month, and the value now will be the occupancy percentage, for example. And looks like we have it set up. So now in three columns we have all the data we need.